Well, sometimes I go out by myself and I look across the water.
Life in the UK is a mixture of many things. It's traditional and modern, energetic and relaxed, and serious and cheerful, all at the same time. It might seem confusing, but it does make sense. This video shows life in one part of the UK, the towns of Warwickshire in England, from the perspective of us, its young people. We hope you enjoy it.
Stop making a fool out of me.
The Gap is a community centre based in Warwick, in the centre of England. It provides activities for the whole community, ranging from baby clinics and playgroups, through youth clubs, sports sessions, and a lunch club for older people. Project Brazil is based at The Gap and aims to involve young people in something that will broaden horizons and develop skills. We're some of the young people involved, and we've already learned a lot from our meetings, fundraising events, and Portuguese lessons. But it's not just us in the UK who have a say in the project. The idea is to form a strong and lasting link with people in Brazil, a link through which we can share experiences and knowledge. Are you here with me? Just looking out on the day. Our part of the country is full of history, of knights, playwrights, and Victorian aristocrats. Warwick Castle, built more than 900 years ago, is the grand old home of former noblemen and women. It has survived many wars and sheltered kings and queens of England. It sits near our homes in Warwick and is now Marcus's favourite tourist attraction. Royal Leamington Spa, a town just next to Warwick, grew quickly during the 19th century. The town became a popular destination for Victorians. Those are the people alive during the reign of Queen Victoria, due to the medicinal qualities of its water. Many of the streets and parks look just like they did nearly 200 years ago. Walking around them often feels like being in a film. Stratford-upon-Avon is about 10 kilometres from Warwick, and was the home of William Shakespeare, a man considered the greatest writer in the English language. It's still possible to visit his birthplace and former school, and many people from around the world still do. Families are often very close in the UK. Although grown-up parents and children sometimes live in different parts of the country, families meet up for holidays. Christmas, with or without snow, is a popular time for families to gather and eat far too much. Although the weather in the UK isn't quite as warm as in Brazil, we do sometimes do things outside. Barbecues are very popular, as are ice creams at the beach. Despite these nice images, there are many young people in the UK who don't have families to spend time with. Although there are many groups, including the Gap Community Centre we're a part of, providing activities and support for these young people, problems do still exist. By doing things like Project Brazil, we can involve the community in reducing some of the bad effects. I don't know whether anyone in the world really likes going to school, but in the UK it isn't too bad. Everyone aged 4 to 16 starts in the morning at about 9 a.m, with lessons going till 3:30 or 4 in the afternoon. Some people go to clubs before or after school, but you don't have to. Lessons include maths, English and science, but we also learn languages, music, sport and lots of other subjects. At 16, you can choose to stay on at school, or you can start to work or enter further training. At 18, more and more people are choosing to go to university, although the cost is rising. Some people choose to travel abroad, or to take time off from the education system, when they've finished school. But not everyone does this. You have to save up enough money. Once finished at school, some people start working straight away. Jobs in the UK have changed a lot over the last few decades. Manufacturing jobs have mainly been replaced by jobs in offices, at least in our part of the country. But the UK still has quite a broad economy, with jobs ranging from farming to banking. The UK is labelled as a developed country, and there certainly are some pretty rich people. But this doesn't mean there aren't lots of people out of work and struggling. This is especially the case outside London. Right now, lots of people are affected by the slow economy. As in any country, we have the most fun when we're not stuck at school or work. There are loads of things to do in the UK. It helps that the country isn't very big, and there are trains going to most places. People obviously like doing different things, but popular trips include visiting theme parks, going to football matches, or spending time in parks or at the beach. As an example, big cities like London are just an hour and a half's drive from where we live. When we stay at home, we like to watch films or TV, read a little bit, or play football or computer games, probably just like in Brazil. We live right at the heart of the country, so we seem to get affected by anything good or bad that's going on. At the moment, the British economy is really slow, meaning that lots of people are struggling to find work. This has made some people feel a bit pessimistic about opportunities. The effects are wide, influencing families, jobs, housing, education, and many other things. But the great thing about community centres like The Gap are that they give anyone a chance to meet people and learn new things, hopefully inspiring them to go out and make a positive difference to society. And there are loads of reasons for British people to be positive. Next year, for example, we have the Olympics coming to our country. And although no one knows what the real legacy will be, you can bet we'll enjoy welcoming visitors to our part of the UK. Well, we hope you enjoyed this quick tour of our small part of our country. We're very excited by Project Brazil and the effects it will have on both our communities. We hope you are too.